We can tell how other people are feeling just by looking at them. When someone is happy, they smile. When they're sad, they frown. This five-part series shall analyze the produced nature of emotion as a science and as something we can completely control. The following are that of muscles used in expressing sadness. Orbicularis oculi, platysma, corrugator supercilium procerus, which furrow the brow, orbicularis oris, which purses the lips, mentalis, which depresses the lower lip, and depressor anguli oris, which is the pulling down of the corners of the mouth. The ending scene to the remake of The Champ has been scientifically recognized and considered to be the saddest movie clip, in accordance with a study into emotion elicitation using films by psychologists Gross and Levinson.
Can't wake up! Wake up!
At the movie's climax, the boxer, played by John Voight, dies in front of his young son, Champ. Wake up, sobs an inconsolable TJ, played by Schroeder. The performance would win him a Golden Globe Award. It would also make a lasting contribution to science. The final scene of The Champ has become a must-see in psychology laboratories around the world when scientists want to make people sad. Since Gross and Levinson gave The Champ two thumbs up as the saddest movie scene they could find, their research has been cited in more than 300 scientific articles. Levinson says he believes the list of films he developed with Gross is the most widely used by emotion researchers. And of the 16 movie clips they identified, The Champ may be the one that has been used the most by researchers. Though he may be using sadness to provoke him, it is important to remember that this is a conscious performance.
Now, in The Champ, you had a big scene, and I know people have asked you this before. You had a scene where you had to cry.
Right.
Now, how do you get in the mood to cry?
Well, I gotta think of something bad. And when you think of something bad, all of a sudden you just start to cry.
And there just tears just come out and ask you?
Mm-hmm.
Is it fair to ask you what you were thinking about that was bad?
Well, I have a couple of secrets stored up there.
Oh, but I don't want to pry.
Well, I'll have one.
Could you tell us one, maybe?
Sure.
I also remember sitting in a closet with my mother, talking about my dead grandmother, to make me cry.
I always think it's...
So actually, that was the way they prepared you to do the emotional scenes.
Yeah, quite abusive.
Yeah.
It wasn't good.
No.
To think about like a trauma like that over and over and over.
Yeah.
I would get warped into a state, emotional state, and then... have to go act, you know, and transfer all those feelings of the dead grandma to him.
What a talent you got.
Yeah, it made a career for me, I guess.
Yeah.
And my mom, my sister, my cousin. Wake up! I think of that and I really start to cry.
Yeah, that would make you cry, wouldn't it?
Yeah. I think you played so well in that movie. Last week, I watched the movie again. I cried the whole movie.
I think of Alan.
You big baby.
Your
men don't cry.
The following are diagrams to show the muscle movements used in producing sadness. A conscious choice to act sad is made in both of these clips.
Please, TJ. The sympathetic nervous system is only there in the event that we allow ourselves to get upset. Our natural state is in the parasympathetic nervous system, where we are at peace and have contentment.
With the idea of conscious choice, it is possible for us as humans to control completely how we feel and experience emotion and expression. With science, humans can be understood, and with this, humans can be produced.
Without this understanding, you will never be at the level of true success that you desire, because you will always be at the whim of your circumstances. You will always be at the whim of other people's opinions, of the ebb and flow of life. When it's up, you're gonna be up. When it's down, you're gonna be way down, right? And all of those things are a result of just old basic programming, old wiring.
Psychologists find that control of emotions can be gained by understanding the stimulus response pattern. When you have certain experiences, you respond with various emotions. Stimulus response. Just as this sort of stimulus produces this sort of involuntary muscular response. Well, that's a rather simplified suggestion of a complex mental process. But you get the idea. Cause, effect.
But few of us realize that our brain creates what is, in effect, a virtual reality. This idea is so contrary to our common sense that few rational people would consider such a proposition to be an important scientific insight that is essential for understanding the human nature, but it is. Conscious experiences, such as our sensations and feelings, are nothing more than evolved illusions generated within biological brains.
We can control all aspects of our feelings, emotions, and reactions. But few will accept this, and even fewer will use this, and instead believe that what they feel is real and genuine.